What? Do 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 do. There we go. It needs to be turned up.
Hey.
All right. I just had a wicked cheese quesadilla and chicken. It was definitely primarily cheese, though. Good lord. Also, beer. Come on! Load. Am I even going?
Tell me who loves orange soda.
That's so loud. Okay, it is going. Oh, that's not soda. Right. There we go. Oh, you put a shirt on.
Put a shirt on. Because I was like, you know what? I'm always wearing a white shirt in these videos. So for
Are
once,
you?
I think most of the time, probably a white shirt or a gray shirt. So I was like, I'm going to put on a blue shirt. Over the white shirt.
Oh, changing it up.
And I'm also wearing the gray shirt under that.
I'm trying to wait till this thing, the app loads, but as usual, it's taking forever.
As per usual.
So I can't check the audio.
Technical difficulties, am I right?
More just like...
Am I right?
A little bit.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, no, it's not like... Oh, here we go. Took that long enough. Oh, and there's an advertisement.
Rated T for teen.
It's...
What game is it?
I don't know.
You know what it's called?
Nope. Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
One Night in Karazhan. Karazhan? Karazhan. I don't know if these are...
Hello.
Alright, well, I think that should be okay.
Mic check 1-2, mic check 1-2. My name is David Frankel, and how are you?
Oh, that was awesome. That was awesome. Play online.
I thought so.
So this stream, by the way, is titled, We Can't Stop Watching Game of Thrones.
We really can't, though, because, alright, how long has season 6 been over now?
A month and a half?
A month and a half.
I guess.
And yet...
Ballparking it?
We decided, you know what? We need to just keep watching Game of Thrones because it's so amazing. We can't let it go. We have issues with letting go.
No, and I mean, also, like, season 6 was a big, like, game changer. Not just the finale and stuff, but just, like, the entirety of the season. So it really... Like, watching season 1 again, you just see so much, like, foreshadowing and nuance and, like, all these crazy subtlety things that you never pick up on before. Like, even when it just comes down to, like, a line or two that... A line in passing that one character says.
Oh, yeah, and it means so much.
And it means so much.
I love it.
Whoop, and there he goes. Get out of the way, dude. Fuck.
Man, this stadium looks like it could be...
It does. This is like the Game of Thrones stadium.
Nice.
I mean, that's what I call. That's what I don't know if it's supposed to be, but.
Oh no, it is.
Okay. No one's hitting the ball, huh? All right. Just kind of letting it sit there. Excuse me.
Oh, no.
Yeah, well, you got in my way. Apparently, I got an epic save and a save. Shit. So that's a good way to start, and so far there's not a lot of lag. So hey.
Hey. All
right. That's a fucking first. That's so irritating. All right. Okay. Hey, excuse me. Bye-bye. Oh, why'd you hit it that way? See, once again, I said this on the last stream, but I'll say it again. The point is not just to hit the ball whenever you can, other team members. The point is to hit the ball in the right goddamn direction, like that.
I feel like we say that every time.
And I have to say it every time because no one ever listens to me.
Exactly. Everyone on here apparently sucks.
Ugh.
Just kidding. Not everybody.
We've actually.
But there's always like there's always people. That one guy.
Oh yeah, for sure.
That one.
Guy. Oh, what a good save though. Because
that
was
a good save. Yeah, that was, you should have got a shot on goal for that.
I know. What the hell? Backward shot. Ooh, spooky. Up. This is one of those games that I can not play for a while and pick right back up and get in that goal. Boom! Even though I didn't get any crazy.
Saber-tooth tiger.
Hey. Oh, little bit of latency on our end. That kind of sucks. Because Time Warner Cable is great.
Real cool, guys. Love all the work you're doing.
Love it.
And clearly you're working.
Whee! Boop. Okay. Hey, guess what? Oh, wait. I don't know if the crowd knows this, but let's tell the story about how our pool was...
defecated in?
Yeah. So, somebody shit in our pool.
Ugh.
And, I mean, that's about all you have to say about it. But I think... listen, David and I are big swimming fans. And, I mean, by swimming, we just enjoy being in the pool.
Who doesn't love being in the pool?
Like...
That is inhumane, if you don't...
Exactly, and I mean, listen, I'm finally on the side of don't even pee in the pool. Come on, that's gross. But for a long time...
And by the way, you say finally, and I find that disgusting.
I know you do.
Utterly... Ugh.
I know, but a lot of people I think are probably...
And everybody out there, that goes for you too, if you...
I'm sure a lot of people think that's okay still. Because, I mean... But the thing is, I mean, the argument that was always there is that, like, that's what the chlorine does. It just gets rid of anything that is pee. Like,
yeah,
it's not pee anymore.
I'll say this about it. If you're gonna do it...
It's a chemical change.
Do it in your own pool. Don't do it in a public
that's
pool.
That's fair.
Or, I'm like, a water park.
Oh, God, that's awful.
Plus, we're in a drought, so, yeah, there's that. Just don't go. But... Yeah, pee in your own pool.
Pee in your own pool.
If you're going to, which I am on team don't ever.
Which, no, I'm with you there now. I mean,
the ocean, however, is a different story.
Everything pees in the ocean.
Everything does. And
like, you're swimming in so much fish and, like, whale and dolphin and shark shit and pee, so.
And, you know, quite frankly, people and whenever people bring their animals.
Oh, for sure.
So... Yeah,
I mean, it's a natural instinct to, when you feel water all over your body, is to let it go. Like that really bad song from Frozen, which I don't understand why people think is good.
Wait, so when you take a shower, you feel like you need to pee?
Sometimes. That's why I pee before I go in the shower. Sometimes I pee in the shower. No, damn it.
Well.
I got bumped. Watch me get a little bumped. It was a little bumpy. It was just the guy in my way. I could have swerved around. And then, what's this guy... That guy, he bumped me. You can't see it, actually. Nice shot. Thanks. Oh, never mind. I was going to type in thanks. It's all right. We're winning. I mean, hopefully that's... Oops, I just went the wrong way. Whoopsie. I totally wasn't paying attention. All right.
Doing great.
Oh, boy.
Fantastic.
Sweet Jesus. We don't have to talk about it. But anyway, peeing in pools, man. Don't do it if it's a public pool. I mean, our pool's not public. It's technically a private pool. But, like, we have an apartment complex of, like, I don't know, 60-plus apartments.
60-something.
So, like, and there's at least two people per apartment, you know what I mean? Not that everybody uses the pool, because I, in fact, don't think many people use it at all. But, like, why did you hit it that way? See? Oh, my God, I don't understand half the people that play this game.
Oh,
thank Christ. I almost just set that guy up. Stop doing that. Oh, my God.
Well, love the people at our apartment.
Oh no, they're actually really—they're all very, very nice. I don't think I've ever had any problems with anybody from our apartment.
Very nicely done.
I needed one.
You were due.
Hey, I was due, and I saw—I literally had the perfect shot, and I also just said, "Fuck that guy." It's like mine.
Leapfrogged him.
I did. It was—it's what we call a juke.
Good old Duke. But yeah, so the shit that was in our pool.
It was literally poop, by the way.
I'm
90% certain.
It's
up to speculation, still, sure. But I mean, it was probably poop.
Because
I mean, all right.
There were speckles, and it was like brown.
Which is, yeah. Ah, please hit it. Oh my god. All right, I did that by accident, but it's okay. No, it's not okay. But yeah, no, okay, so this was like when I first got back from my trip to visit my family in Maine. I was going to go hang out with somebody, and we were going to go swimming in my pool or our pool. And but then, like, you know, we decided, oh, we'll go to that your pool instead. So that's what we did. Please hit it out. God, for the love of shit, please hit it out. And so I ended up going there. And when I got back here, I got a Snapchat from David that just had a picture of a caution tape surrounding our pool. And then I didn't read the, I don't remember what the paper
there was,
said.
There was a sign that MVP, there it is.
And there's no goddamn lag this time. Wait, I gotta do the thing. There we go. I like doing that.
Sitting up.
Oop, knocked over your wife.
Well, rude.
Rude. But yeah.
So yeah, the sign said something to the effect of pool closed for maintenance. It didn't say maintenance. It was something about cleaning. Until August 5th or sooner.
And it was August 5th, by the way. Like, it wasn't sooner.
No, yeah, it was not sooner. And this was, like, July, whenever you left.
When I got back on July... I left on the 13th, or 12th. I got back on the 20th. So, yeah, it was, like, a solid 15, 16 days of closed pool. And it
was hot. No, wasn't it when you left, though?
No, it happened when I got back.
Because I thought it happened the same day that you were supposed to go swimming here.
No, the swimming day was not that day. That was the day I went downtown, was the day I left. And then the swimming day was the day I got back.
Ah, okay.
I literally did things the day I left and the day I got back. And one of them was going downtown and the other one was going swimming. It's kind of like bookending. It's like the beginning and the end of my trip, so I have a very vivid memory of both of those things.
Got it.
So don't worry, I got that. But like, no, it was the day I got back. So it was like the 20th that it happened. So it was for 16 days. Also, since we live in the valley, it's hot as balls all the time, and like having a pool is genuinely probably good for your health.
Oh, absolutely.
So you don't die of heat stroke. And there's bunts there. You totally fucked that guy shot up. But yeah, so it was just painstakingly awful for a while. So.
Yeah, and again, you know, love the people that live in our building, but our suspects are the children.
Yeah, the kids.
Because they were in the day that it happened. I left the apartment to go do whatever it was I was doing that day. Don't remember. But it's also not important. So I left, and you know, I saw like. Basically, like, it seemed like all the kids that live in the building were in the pool. When I got back and, you know, saw the sign and the caution tape surrounding the pool, at first I saw, like I said, I saw those dark speckles at the bottom of the pool. And my first two thoughts were, okay, either, you know, it's like blood. Oof. Like someone like got in a shit. Serious accident here or that shit
or it's poo-poo.
And now full disclosure, we haven't actually confirmed that it's shit, but it's shit.
No, it's for sure shit. Like, are you kidding me? They went on a closer for that long? Because like,
yeah,
I mean, here's... Ooh, someone died. Boop! Nice. Oh, clear ball over that guy with a backwards smash. Nice. Oh, sorry, you just breakdanced a bit. But yeah, so that was kind of the story. And we finally... And it also, here's the
thing... Oh!
And here's the thing that bothered me, though, the most, was that the day it opened again, you weren't home, I remember. I was like, oh, cool, the pool's back open again. I'm going to tell David. But instead of telling him, hey, man, just the pool's open, I noticed right away that the kids were back in the pool immediately. They were the first ones to use it again. And I was like, no, fuck you. You should have your pool rights taken away because you can't control your bowels because you're a tiny child. Like, I don't think it was the kids. Was it the kids that were kind of, like, talking to us yesterday while we were swimming? Like,
well, I mean, they were...
They were part of that group.
Some of the kids.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
So, I mean, they're suspects.
They're suspects. All right.
Every child is a suspect.
Every child is a suspect. Although I feel like whoever did it wouldn't want to be seen near that pool ever again out of shame.
You would think so.
If it was me, I would never go to that pool ever again. Like, if... Ugh. Yeah, if I shit in the pool, I wouldn't go back. I would never go swimming in that pool again. Ever. Like, because I'd feel so much shame. And, like, maybe that's just because I'm an adult.
But, I mean, that's a good point.
I did shit my pants last year, though. Which I love that story. I think I told that story on a stream before, but... It was good stuff.
It wasn't, but...
I was drunk, as I usually am. And I shit while hanging out with a couple friends. We were just kind of like hanging out on the street because I lived on a side street, and this was at my old place of rest, my old place of
just living with Pat.
Living with Pat.
And Soju.
That would have been a great show, but it'd just been cute though. It wouldn't have been funny. Oh. Although Soju did some funny things.
Oh, Soju was hilarious. He was my little buddy.
But But no, so I was living on my own, and I remember it was auditions for the conservatory. It was right after the conservatory auditions for Second City. And I was nervous, because I wasn't sure how I did. I ended up getting in, thankfully, but I was just nervous. And I went to the bar first, and I had two beers. And I don't condone drinking and driving, but I drove home after two beers. It's not like two beers did anything, I know. Not cool, though, so don't do that. But I was nervous as shit, so I did that. But then I got home, and I had... Nice. And then I got home, and I had two more beers, and I polished off a bottle of Cab that I had sitting on my shelf. And it was like a glass and a half of Cab. And so I was drunk. And then I got a text message from our friend David, another David friend, David Stewart. And he was just like, hey, man, we're going to go to Bob's Big Boys. You want to come? And I was like, fuck yeah, let's do it. Just fucking do this. And so we ended up going to Bob's, and I had a bunch of fried food, which was helping at the time. And then we were like, afterward, we kind of like went back on my street, and me, David, and another one of our friends, I don't exactly remember who it was, and we were all just kind of hanging out and talking. And I was leaning against David's car. We were all talking about it's Always Sunny in Philadelphia and other fun stuff. And then that was an amazing, unfair shot. And then all of a sudden I remember being like, I remember thinking to myself, I have to fart. I should just let that out slowly and casually. And I didn't. It wasn't that. I pooped. I just pooped. It wasn't a lot of poop. Oof. Like, because I feel like that's the treasure of being an adult, is I can stop myself from pooping. And so it was just a little bit. I threw the underwear away. You bet.
Oh,
I did.
Did you now?
Oh, for sure. The pants, it didn't touch the pants. So I didn't have to throw the pants away. Although I think I threw them away since, because they just got ruined. But
by your shit.
No, I like got a big hole ripped in the butt, I think. Ooh. But
because of your shit.
Because of my shit. But no, so they're gone now. But see, I understand loose bowels. I do. That's what they call me, loose bowels. That's a dumb joke. But I understand it. But guys, if you think you might have a poop coming, poop before you go swimming. Poop before you go swimming. Just do that. It. Do that for me.
Just be cautious.
Be cautious.
Be careful out there.
Be careful. No, it's a dangerous world for you never know when a surprise Snickers bar is going to appear in the pool. You're just floating in there. You're wiggling around a bit. It's all right. Let's shake it off, David.
Wizard-looking motherfucker.
Keep knocking your water over. God damn it.
And I keep not caring.
That's not my problem. That's not my problem, Pat. All right. Hey, you got the MVP on our
team. This water's no good. I keep spilling it on myself.
Do you really?
Yeah, this is no good. You broke it. You broke my water.
I don't know why I keep hitting buttons and nothing's happening.
Broke my water. My water broke.
Oh my god, we gotta get him to the hospital. Oh, I love this map. Ah. This is like the, this
childbirth
is like...
Childbirth jokes.
Hey!
That's what you'll get here.
That's what you'll get at FunTea, is childbirth jokes. Mm. Because
who
better to talk about childbirth than two dudes?
Probably sucks.
Probably, it probably does. I mean,
probably.
It's a magical thing, but at the same time, it probably sucks.
And from all accounts, it sucks.
It sucks.
A lot.
Yeah, I mean, like, I give a lot of credit to pregnant women. Shout out to the pregnant women out there. We love you. FunTea supports pregnant women. I mean, yeah, I guess. Like, it's not like we don't.
Don't come looking at me for childbirth. port.
There it is.
Checks.
Well, it's not like you don't have any kids, so you're okay. You don't have to worry about that unless you have kids.
I know, but you're saying that we support pregnant women.
Well, yeah. So what if, like, I mean, if they want to be pregnant, you know, I mean, that's getting political. we'll avoid that topic. But
I feel like talking about pregnancy.
It's just going to get there. It's just going to get there.
This is.
We're walking a thin line, especially being two dudes.
No, dude, this is great.
Oh,
this is,
no.
This is what the people want.
Oh, that guy's a hero.
Right?
I'm not trying.
Like, comment, subscribe, and let us know.
About childbirth.
About childbirth.
Do you think we should talk about childbirth more? Let us know in the comment section down below. I missed. I love this map, by the way. Hey, we scored.
It's a good map.
Yay. Boop. Nice. So shout out to Cactus Tachiera, because I've had Cactus Tachiera for about 4 or 5 nights in the past 8 days. I've gotten a chicken and cheese quesadilla, so I am filled to the brim with
amazing
dairy and chicken.
I had a California burrito today. C-Raj just decided to
not play. He's just not playing.
But yeah, they have amazing food.
No, for those who don't know what a California burrito is, would you like to share what a California burrito is? And why did that bother
you? No, because I want them all to myself.
I mean, they can make more.
But I want those.
I want all of them. They are one of the most amazing things I've had.
Burrito, it's amazing, definitely. You get your choice of meat, any meat that they have, and they have a lot. They even have, like, lingue, stomach and cheek and tongue and all that crazy stuff. I usually get chicken.
Do they have stomach and cheek and tongue? Never mind. Go ahead.
The meat?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, they have.
I did not know that
stuff. Yeah, it's authentic as fuck.
no, cool. I mean, that's awesome.
Yeah.
I don't want it, but no, I'm fine with chicken.
Chicken's good. Or, you know, some carne asada or carnitas. You know, those are like my three that I usually get. But tonight I got chicken. So it has beans, rice, traditionally, I don't know if they all have guacamole.
No, it's usually sour cream.
They all have sour cream, but some do put guacamole in there. Cactus does not, but it's okay. It, you know, doesn't need it. There's so much going on anyways. You know, you got onion. Mm. And then the most important part to make it Californian, French fries.
Yeah, French fries.
Potato burritos in general are awesome. And so this way you're just getting french fries in your burrito.
Yeah.
And it's amazing. So I love to add Cholula. They have a couple different like house salsas that they have that they make that are excellent.
Fuck you.
I always add those too. Fuck you, man.
Fuck you, man. Yeah, so that's our rant about Cactus Tachiera.
Yeah.
And
so now that you're hungry.
Yeah. I want to talk about something that I have no reference point of because I haven't seen it.
Okay.
Suicide Squad.
Suicide Squad.
Because I've heard nothing but bad things about that movie. Coming from people, though, who understand somewhat of a process of making a movie. Whether it's the writing process, whether it's the, you know, production and the direction and, like, the effects or whatever. And from everything I heard, the only good thing about Suicide Squad was, like, the fact that they had a good cast. Like, it is good actors, and, like, everybody was good in it, even though they got shitty dialogue and a shitty plot, and, like, everything about it was just so, like, who cares? That was, like, I watched it was the Funhouse podcast, the Dude Soup podcast, which is the one, and the takeaway I got from that is no one cares. Like, no one cared about anything that went on in that movie, which is a huge shame, because I wanted it to be good. Because it's anti-hero movies we haven't seen in a while, except for, like, Deadpool, which was fucking amazing. but, like, it was just unfortunate. And you know somebody who saw it, too, right?
Yes, I do. One of the first things I had heard... Nice bicycle.
Thank you.
one of the first things I heard was it was okay.
Yeah.
Jared Leto was surprisingly not awful, but he was just...
Jared Leto?
Jared Leto. You know, 30 seconds to... and from everything else I've heard since then, though, that was the nicest review that I've heard of it. Because, I've been hearing the same thing. Mostly junk. I know that there was, like, a faction of people that apparently were trying to... I forget exactly what it was, but, like, maybe you heard about this with Rotten Tomatoes. Like, they were trying to get the review taken down, all the bad reviews, because they're,
fanboys.
Fanboys, and just in general, a little too attached.
Yeah.
They must be in Egypt because they're in denial.
Lol. But really, though, it's like, well, apparently, like, the process, the whole development process of it, too, is, like, they announced the movie, like, 2 years ago at Comic-Con, and then they were all like, oh, I guess we actually have to make it now. Like, that was the thing. It wasn't like, I mean, love or hate the Marvel movies, and I genuinely like the Marvel movies. I think that they're good movies. I mean, some of them are better than others. But, like, you can watch one, and here's the thing, and here's another point that the Funhouse guys made that I totally agree with. Who gives a flying fuck?
Nice.
Thank you. Who gives a flying shit about... like Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor, especially Thor. But they did a good enough job in those movies where you actually kind of got I got really excited when there's a scene in the first Avengers movie, and this is the one they were talking about specifically, and they're totally right. When Captain America, Thor, and Iron Man are in the woods together. And I won't spoil it because I know you haven't seen it yet. And I think the first Avengers movie is worth seeing. I really, really do. And even though if you're not a fan of comic book movies, it's a good movie to watch.
Yeah.
It really is.
Also, full disclosure, I have only seen the original first two Spider-Men and
Civil War.
I saw Civil War because I was with a friend, but it might have been a date, but...
Still not sure about that. But yeah, so we saw that even though I hadn't seen literally any other Marvel movies. So continue.
So yes, but no, so like, yeah, see the first Avengers. It's actually really good.
Okay.
And it's well directed, it's well shot, it's really fun. But you're in this map, the one that you wanted to play on but glitched out last time.
To
play on it. Yay.
Yeah, this is a sweet map. But, I have heard that the first Avengers is really good. Joss Whedon directed it, and he's awesome. And then also, I met the cinematographer for that movie as well, and he's phenomenal. He's, an Academy Award-winning cinematographer. Seamus McGarvey. I think McGarvey?
Say McGarvey. I've heard the name.
And he's a super nice guy, but super talented. So I'm sure the two of them. Like I said, I've heard it's great, and I don't doubt that one bit.
Nice. But yeah, so like there was a scene in that movie where like those three characters, Thor, Captain America, and Iron Man, are all like the three of them are kind of together, and it's like the first time they meet, and you're actually like, this is awesome. These three very different characters from very different stories, they're here. They're together in the same area. Holy shit. And it's like compelling, and then all of a sudden you watch Batman v Superman or something, and you're like, Batman and Superman are in the same movie together, and you don't give a fuck. Like, who are... And honestly, Batman and Superman are the most iconic superheroes, I think. Maybe, like, the follow-up to that is maybe Spider-Man. But, like, yeah, but who's more iconic than Batman and Superman? And no one cares. Like, because I saw Batman v Superman, and let me tell you, yeah, it was... My review of it was, I knew what they were trying to do. I respect what they were trying to do. I think Ben Affleck is actually a good Batman. I do, and I actually think when they do the Batman movie, because they're making a standalone Batman movie, and Ben Affleck is directing it and obviously starring in it, I think that might be good, because it's Ben Affleck. And I trust him. I mean, he's a Bostonian, so I kind of have to. But we'll see.
But Ben Affleck is a homie, for sure.
Yeah, for sure. And, like, but, I mean, they're like the thing about the Marvel movies is they're so meticulously planned. They had the plans for the main villain Thanos back when they decided to like make more Marvel movies. Like, I mean, the first one that was really made that they decided to bounce springboard off of was the first Iron Man movie, which is also great. The first Iron Man movie was fucking awesome. And that's the one where they were like, you know what? Like, we can totally do this. Because that was very successful. So they're like, we can make Captain America movies. We can make Thor movies. We can make the Hulk with Ed Norton, unfortunately, that got... although don't get me wrong, Mark Ruffalo is hilariously good. Because he's hilarious. No, he's hilarious because his character is actually kind of funny.
He's a funny guy.
He's a funny guy. And he's super snarky and sarcastic in as Bruce Banner. So that's good. But, like... But no, like, you know, and then they got to, they planned out, nice, save. They planned out so meticulously the way Marvel was going to go, which is why those movies are so successful, where these ones, I mean, even Batman v Superman, all those, like, extra scenes that they added in about, you know, the Flash and Cyborg and Aquaman, they were just thrown in at the very end of it. They were like, oh, we got to do this real quick. And even with Suicide Squad, they went back and they shot more scenes they probably didn't need to have. And then they threw that in. And also, apparently, as exciting as Jared Leto was as the Joker, apparently no one gave a shit about the Joker. He wasn't like... And the only character that really interacted with the Joker was Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
Like, nobody else really interacted with the Joker. It's like, well, what the fuck was the point then?
I love that story that that Will Smith... Leto.
I actually have to retract my original excitement about it. It was a satire piece, and I'm pissed about it.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So there was a satire piece going around, and I didn't read where it was from, which is where it was.
You screwed me.
And I was so pissed. It said that it was just a funny-ass fake Will Smith interview that he hates Jared Leto. And he just doesn't even get it, and it was so funny. But it read so true to me that, like, because I read the whole thing. I read the article. I did not see where it was from, though, and then I noticed it was above, I think it was called, like, Above Average or something like that. They're a satire. I think it's that's the that was the. I'm correct me if I'm wrong, but like, yeah, it was. And then I read it, and then I was like, no, this is satire. That totally sucks. Although that being said, I will say something about Jared Leto, that I don't give a fuck about him, at all.
Yeah.
As an actor, as a musician, I don't care.
Nope.
I found out that my sister's favorite band is 30 Seconds to Mars. I gave my sister so much shit for it. She's like, I love him. And I was just like, you know, he's a giant jackass, right? Like,
he's a tool.
He's a huge tool. Because, like, Jared Leto needs to get over himself. He's a good actor. I will give him, he's a good actor. He's good.
Yeah, no,
I've seen him in some great
roles. He's not a bad actor.
But he just... look at Leonardo DiCaprio. Arguably one of the best actors. Not up his own ass all the time.
No, Leo's tight as hell.
Yeah.
And I want to hang out with Leo.
I would hang out with Leo in a heartbeat.
If you're watching, let's hang out, dude.
Leo, seriously, though, dude. Like, you live in L.A. We live in L.A. Let's hang out. Probably lives in, like, Malibu or something. Get it. Nice. Dude, your team has been saving like clutch this entire game.
Yes, they have.
Saving like clutch. That's not the right way to say that, but you know what? Who cares? But yeah, I just wanted to bring out Suicide Squad and stuff because I'm really I wanted it to be good, and I think that's like the worst part is. You know what I mean?
Actually, you know what? The other thing I heard about it too is apparently. Sorry, I'm just disappointed. I didn't get anything. Hey, I played defense. That's what I do. Stats that don't show up on the scorecard, but defense wins championships.
You literally got 80 points, but you played defense. Right. I watched.
I got more than their second two best players.
Get your water bottle over again.
Again, I don't care.
I still don't care.
But I do believe an apology is in order.
I apologize, didn't I? No. I apologize.
Not well enough.
Okay. Sorry, man. I'm on the cord. Oh, my guitar pick. Whoop.
So the other thing apparently that held back Suicide Squad was the PG-13 rating.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Unfortunately, a syndrome that a lot of movies suffer from.
And they almost got it with Deadpool, too. But Deadpool was like, fuck you. Like, no. Don't show your kid this movie. And I love Deadpool so much. It was such a good movie. You still haven't seen Deadpool, right?
I still have not. I am looking forward to seeing it, though. I've heard nothing but good things.
It's good. It's great. Because it takes superhero movies and just gives it the middle finger, literally. Like, it's exactly what we needed to see. It's like a good palate cleanser for superhero movies. Although, to be completely honest, after seeing Batman v Superman and hearing everything I have about Suicide Squad, I am very much, like, looking forward to seeing Marvel movies again. Because I'm like, these guys do it okay. Like, these ones are good. I know that.
Yeah.
So, like, that's why I'm like, you got... I had no control. I still have no control over anything right now. None of that was me.
It was a shitstorm ranch.
It was a shitstorm ranch.
Babe.
If you want to talk about something that's amazing, there's a show that a little show called Trailer Park Boys. There's the leg. That is one of my favorite shows. Like, it has become one of my absolute favorite shows in such a short amount of time. I haven't had to give it a lot of thought. Like,
no, I mean, it's just amazing.
The first, like, what, four seasons are a little weird and kind of like, okay, what is this show about?
I'd say the first season is a little slow, but like, it really starts to, like, the second season it picks up a bit, and then it just kind of keeps escalating from there in the best of ways. So yeah, for me, I'd just say the first season is like, gotta kind of get through.
Yeah.
But once you do,
it's cool. Such a funny show, and it's, please don't, okay. Please don't. Every time it like slowly starts going in, I just want to be delicate. I'm like, no. like I even pull back. I don't know if you can see me, but I'm like, sorry. It's okay. Sorry. I actually say sorry like that to people at the grocery store when I bump into them. I'm like, oh, sorry. I make them think I'm Canadian. I'd try to convince people I'm Canadian. I would do that. I'm not, but...
All right, let's start a new challenge, everybody. This is...
The Canadian Challenge. It raises awareness for Canadians. It's like the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge, only it's about Canadians. Which is America's top hat. Which is exactly what it is. I like Canada. I've been to Canada. It's great. Hey, look at that. And the Olympic Games have started.
And Pat Weston scores for Canada.
For Canada. Ooh, no. I am an American. I already have
Canada
it.
Canada seems pretty cool.
It's beautiful up there. I went to the falls, man.
Ah.
I went to that city. Which I forget what city that is. Is that Quebec?
Niagara Falls.
Yep. Bingo. But I went there, and it was beautiful, and I actually very much liked it. And yes, no, the stereotype of, like, pretty... Do you mind, dude? Like, like, fuck off.
It's like, hold me.
Hold me, Pat. Hold me like you used to on the farm. Do you remember the farm? Do you remember strawberries with cream, Frodo? Sorry.
I was thinking Walking Dead as far.
Ugh. Like, what a great season that was. That was an awful season of television.
Let's get off the farm.
David and I we can get kind of critical over TV sometimes, and movies, but The Walking Dead, we want so much to be a show that's up there with, like, Breaking Bad and Game of Thrones, well, but it's not.
Here's the thing, I've given up on that hope.
Same here.
All right, so here's the thing. The first season of The Walking Dead was... probably the best season.
Yeah, it was so good.
Yeah, because you want to know why? Because Frank Darabont was the executive producer and showrunner, and that show had so much potential. And then they fired him. Just like
that. Similar to that. Ooh. I'm playing.
Yeah, so... Then it just kind of went downhill from there, and
I'm still gonna watch it.
That's the thing. I kept watching it because it had so much promise, and it was like it's not that it immediately got bad, because they still had great moments in the next couple seasons.
Yeah. Well, yeah. No, there were some incredible scenes and things that happened.
Yeah.
For sure.
But then as time went on, they lost it, and by the time that I had realized that, like, it was never coming back. It was never going to be the show that it could have been.
Yeah.
I was too deep that, you know, I was like, okay, I can't have wasted my time, so now I have to watch it. So that it's not a big waste of time. And sure, I'd like to see how the hell they're going to wrap this thing up.
Yeah.
Which,
yeah. Honestly, how can they wrap this show up? Like, that's the weird thing about The Walking Dead is, like, the zombie apocalypse, it just doesn't end. And yeah. Obviously, and once it was established that, like, it doesn't matter if you get bit or not. Once you die at all, you turn into a zombie. Like, once that was revealed, it's like, well, then there's no point in any of this. So, like,
yeah.
You might as well just all kill yourselves and just become zombies and live as zombies. Like, yeah. Fuck this world. It's a miserable shit show.
That's
like,
they kind of wrote themselves into a corner.
Yeah, I mean, that's actually, that was, like, the plot line in the comics, too, though, was that, like, it doesn't matter. We're all, and as they, and in the comics it says, we're all walking dead. That's literally in the comics. But it's okay, because the comics, apparently, which I have not read all of them, I read the first volume, which was great, Days Gone By, which was wonderful, and it was pretty much the exact same thing as season one. Especially the first episode was, like, identical to season... No! That's so annoying. Fine, but yeah, episode one and, like, the first chapters of volume one were just, like, literally word for word. Same with the first book, first Game of Thrones, and the first season of Game of Thrones, almost identical.
Nice.
It was really well done. And then things went a little off the rails. But.
You know, I have heard that the comics are really good, though.
Yeah.
As well, so... Yeah, I don't know, that's... Come on, guys. That's all I'm asking.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's a little late now, though. I mean, like, here's the thing. I mean, I think Dave and I are both on agreements here that, like, we haven't actually seen the most recent season that just ended, but we're waiting for it to go on Netflix. Like, at least that's what I'm doing. I'm waiting for it to go on Netflix. Yeah, like, I've seen... So I haven't seen the most previous one. I know what happens at the end because everybody and their mother spoiled it for me, but, like, I don't know, like, what... Who, but I know what happened. Oh, my God! That was so actually very impressive of the defense. Like, way to go, defense.
Yes, it was. Yeah.
Like, I ain't even mad. That was... If we lose this game, what a deserving loss.
Oh, yeah.
Get out of here.
Send
him to the moon. All right.
But, what were we?
The Walking Dead. And how we're going to watch it on Netflix because we're not going to pay for it.
Yeah. Because it's not worth it.
No.
So, yeah, I feel like there was a larger point we were getting at, but you know, just that's what it is. Do you think that they'll? I remember what I was gonna say. I worry that it's going to keep going. Awesome way to win.
Yeah, thank you.
By the way, awesome. I'm worried that it's gonna. He's just shitting everywhere.
I just took off. I look like a rocket.
Goodbye. Goodbye, Pat.
Goodbye. That's what I have to do from now on.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
So despite our lack of enthusiasm for the Walking Dead, there are a tremendous amount of people that still love that show.
And I don't hate it. I just wish it took different turns.
Yeah.
I just wish it went a little differently. I couldn't have done a better job. I know that for a fact. I'm not a good enough writer nor director nor anything like that. But, so I'm not saying that, like, I should have done it. No, I shouldn't have done it. I would not have done well. Like, I don't have that kind of directing experience. The things that I have directed are sketches, and that's it. So that's my directing experience. I've directed short films for college projects and high school projects, but not a high budget... big money blockbuster TV show like Walking Dead. So no, I have no experience in that way.
Well, thank you for your IMDb.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Shit, what was I saying?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, at least I...
The Walking Dead is a show that exists.
It exists. It does. Oh, yeah, okay. This is second time. I worry that it's going to keep going because there are so many people that do love it, and it makes them so much money that they're just going to keep cranking it out until it stops making them money. Because that's essentially what this show is now, is like, it's not like an amazing show like, you know, Breaking Bad and, you know, Game of Thrones, and it is not up there. It's just, it's simply not. but what it is marketable and profitable, and and I think the, you know, the network heads recognize that, but you know, just keep patting everybody on that show on the back and telling them what a great job they're doing.
Yeah, and I mean, another thing about Walking Dead 2 is like, I don't care a lot about the characters.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, they whatever. Killed off most of the good ones, anyways.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Like, don't get me wrong, I like Rick, sure, but he's kind of, I don't know.
He turned into a zombie once Laurie died.
Yeah, he's like a wet paper towel.
Yeah.
Like, and then Carl's still annoying.
Carol, where's Carl? Marshall. What, Rick? We can't trust you anymore. Why not, Rick? Because you don't have a good head on your shoulders. Herschel. What, Rick? We can't trust you. Why not? Because you don't have a leg to stand on. Thank you. Thank you.
That's good stuff. But it's so true. He does, and he's dead.
Yeah.
His character, I actually really liked Herschel. I thought Herschel was good. And then he died.
And then he died. He died. Shane died. That love triangle was a really interesting dynamic. And then they were like, okay, no more.
I was okay that Shane died because he was an asshole.
He was.
He was a bad guy. So
he was.
Bad guys needed to die.
But it just made for an interesting dynamic in the
great.
Show.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, if anything, like,
that's
they probably did it too
two.
Early. Yeah, that's
yeah,
it.
Right?
Season two, exactly.
That's what took me through season two, because nothing else did.
Yeah.
Because that's when Herschel sucked.
Yeah.
Because Herschel sucked at the beginning, because he's all like, we can cure them, we can cure the zombies. It's like, you can't.
You can't, Herschel.
He hit them all in the barn, and that's where Sophie was.
Spoiler. Alert.
If you haven't seen season two by now and you're not going, fuck off. Like,
yeah.
I don't care.
No, it's
my
true.
My spoiler rule, by the way, is essentially like, it kind of depends on the product given. But if it's like a mainstream, big mainstream thing, like something like Game of Thrones or Walking Dead or something like that, you got 2 months before I'm spoiling it for you. I still won't spoil season six yet of Game of Thrones. Wait until the end of August, and I will talk about it forever, unless of course we say spoiler alert first. Booyakasha. Hey, have you won a game yet?
How many games did I play? One or two?
Three. This is your fourth.
I definitely won the first one.
Or this is your third. I don't know.
This might be my third. I lost the last one, won the first one. Yeah, I think this is my third.
Okay. We'll play. We'll each play one more after this. And then we'll wrap it up and watch more Game of Thrones.
Oh, hell yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, like I said, I'm not going to spoil Game of Thrones unless, of course, I have an intended spoiler, like, podcast and or stream where I say I'm spoiling the Game of Thrones.
You will be so kind.
Yeah, I'll spoil season 5 of Game of Thrones. Jon Snow gets stabbed at the end by the Night's Watch.
Ah, that's not cool, man. That's cool.
That is cool. Why is that not cool? It's been out for over a year.
I know, but like, what if someone like hasn't started the show and like,
fuck them. That's their fault for being behind.
I have sympathy for you.
I don't. Get on the times. Like, because
oh,
also, like, here's the thing, we're an entertainment group. Like, we have to be able to talk about this kind of stuff. Like, or else, what are we gonna do?
I guess I'm just I hate spoilers.
I understand. No, I actually do too. But it's one of those things. It's like, it's been out for over a year. If you haven't seen it yet, then that's your problem. Like, it's.
But there's just so many things to watch. Like, where do you start? And,
but Game of Thrones is better than most of the other things you can watch.
I understand that. I agree.
It's very good. It's a very good show.
That's why I just need to get into office and enact a law that orders everybody to watch Game of Thrones, and we won't have that problem.
Exactly.
That's.
Everybody
there you
gets
go.
Free HBO.
Or at least, like, you know.
Free Game of Thrones.
Have, like, that be part of my platform is, like, you know, Game of Thrones awareness and, you know, greatness awareness.
Another HBO show that is now has become one of my personal favorite shows ever is Last Week Tonight with John Oliver.
Oh, the love
that
show. That
has become one of my... Because here's the thing. John Oliver doesn't hold back on anybody. Like, he is not, like, he's not nice to anybody. I mean, he's particularly mean to Donald Trump, but he makes it easy. That's his fault for making it so easy. But God, what an and he brings up amazing stories that don't ever get told in the news. Like, he talks about really important stuff. And like, that's what's so amazing about that show. So, you know, if you haven't gone over, and that's also very funny. At the very end of the day, whether or not you agree with some of the stuff that's being said, it's so funny.
Very funny.
Ooh, he's still on the court. And there it is.
Thanks for mouth. Thanks for jinxing
open my
it.
Mouth. Literally.
We were going for the
half a second soon.
I mean, you would be the guy to put your arm around
the
pitcher
baby,
who's throwing a perfect game and ask him how it's going.
I am walking bad luck. It's true. I fall up the stairs. I drop everything. The other night, I shattered one of our glasses, which was the first break that we had in our apartment. We've lived in this apartment for over a year now. Haven't broken anything. I was kind of drunk, so I'll say that. But like, as I usually am. He's trying to do the thing. Don't do flips. These flips aren't fun. You just want to do. What the hell is that thing?
Odd World Moloch.
Looks semi-familiar, but I couldn't place it if you asked.
Looks like Evil Admiral Ackbar.
Put your arms around me, baby.
But, born under a bad sign. If it wasn't for bad luck.
Nah.
Luck.
I don't believe in luck. Watch your feet. I don't run over your toes.
Luck be a lady.
Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady, or luck if you ever were a lady to begin with. I do like show tunes. That's one of my favorite musicals, actually. Guys and Dolls? A good one.
And Action Figures?
No.
That's the sequel I'm working on. I'm writing a sequel to Guys and
Dolls. Guys and Dolls and Action Figures?
And Action Figures.
That would actually be really funny if you, like, made a really good, like, kind of not political, that's not it. Like parody, there we go, of that, but you know, that'd be funny.
I'll make a political parody.
Kind of like Hamlet 2. Did you ever see Hamlet 2?
Hamlet.
I saw Hamlet 2.
Was it on par with like Leprechauns 2 and 3?
Well, Hamlet 2 was about essentially a failed drama teacher trying to write Hamlet 2. And it was okay. I thought it was funny.
Was it a comedy?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Okay, I remember.
I forget who was the star in it. Was it Sacha Baron Cohen? No.
No, no, no. It was, fuck, I forget his name. He's hilarious, though. I was just watching an episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm that he, like, guest stars in.
To the moon!
Hey, zoom! To the moon!
I like how that guy hit it and left. And those guys didn't do anything. They're not even playing.
That's
all right.
Anybody could do that.
Not do anything?
Not do anything.
They're still not doing anything.
Yeah, you really... This is an episode of The Twilight Zone.
You know what?
Everybody is frozen in time.
Fine.
Hey, just rack up your score, man.
Sure, fuck it. I don't care. I played 3 legitimate games and won all 3. So... I don't care. I'll play one absolute joke of a game. I mean, let's just have some fun here. Moving it over.
Is this fun?
I don't care. I don't want to restart a game. Like, I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to keep scoring goals.
Nice. Hey, yeah. And by the way, for all the professionals and scouts out there for Rocket League, we are legitimately trying to go pro. If you look back at any of our videos, we talk about how we are trying to go pro.
Hey, there's a person playing.
Nice. It's a goal of mine.
It's a fun ass game.
It's a fun game, and I treat it with respect and honor, and I want to go pro in it.
Good. I had to let somebody else score.
I mean, you could have got the assist.
Ah! It's all right. I did hit that over there, though. That was me. So, I should have gotten the assist. I got the spiritual assist.
Spiritual?
Spirit That's Awards. A thing. I have tomorrow off. Oh my god. Wait, doesn't
know. You don't have to live tomorrow?
I can die. By the way, I mean, scouts out there, like David was saying, just take a peek at all these wonderfully set up shots that I've given myself, even. I mean, a lot of these goals, sure, are uncontested. Uncontested, that's arguable. There's other teams. There's another team, see? I just want to point out that I am a very good shot. So, just... Somebody else want to get one? There you go. Are you serious? I could have gotten that one in, but I didn't because I suck. Don't
go chasing waterfalls.
Don't go chasing waterfalls. We're just playing pass. We're passing it. Whoop. Hey, wow. It still counts as a win, and I still get the MVP.
Prodigy.
To the moon! It's so funny! Just... Alright, David, play your last game, man.
Alright.
Because mine was a goddamn joke.
Okay. Oh, wait. No, I want to not play against those guys, damn it.
Well, there'll more people will come in. Don't worry about it. You got the little white car.
Whee!
Yeah. Whee! So I wrote a blog today that...
Today?
I wrote a blog today about sex. And it's one of those blogs that I wrote that always makes my asshole clench. I'm not going to talk about the blog. I'm going to talk about the process of it. Sometimes writing.
So this blog about sex makes your asshole clench?
Yes. And it's due to the simple fact that my blogs are opinion pieces for the most part. You know, it's nice flight time.
Thank you.
My blogs for the most part are kind of opinion pieces where, like, I mostly write blogs based off of my observations of the way things are. And I wasn't talking about, and first of all, and like I just said in this too, I'm not making a blog negatively about sex. I think sex is important. I think sex is awesome. I think it's healthy. And I think it's wonderful. That being said, I talked about, and as you put it, actually, which is the way I should have kind of introduced it in the first place, was that it's not about sex so much as it's about people. And because like you put it that way, and I was like, that's way better that I said it, which I just kept saying, sex is good. It's not about that. And it's about the way sex is approached. But that's like the thing that makes my butthole clench, is that there are going to be so many people that read that blog and go, yeah, but that's not me. And I'm gonna be like, yeah, but that's not for you then. Like, if this isn't you, then that's not for you. Like, then don't fucking read the blog. Like, it's not about you.
Yeah, a lot of people have problems, getting offended by things that, you know, just aren't directed towards
them. I had a close call with a good friend of mine earlier about that. But then we talked about it, and she's like, no, 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 what? I don't care. Like, she's like, no, it's not about me. I know that. And I'm like, okay, never mind. Not you. But there are other people that, yeah, they'll claim that not necessarily it's about them, but that they have to be able to relate to it. And I think that's kind of a problem with a lot of things, not just blogs and stuff like that, but I think that's to do with, I mean, you could speak politically about that too, even, about how people, like, if they don't connect to it and they don't relate to it, then it's not right. You know what I mean? It's a very broad, but no, I think that it's absolutely, but I think it's absolutely worth, I'm trying to think of a good example for it. Like, I don't want to do it with the sex one because I kind of abused that one today on the blog, but like, by the way, follow my blog. It's this kid is screwed on Google's Blogger. Go on Blogger and type in this kid is screwed and that's mine. I write a lot of political stuff in there. So, you know, that's a thing. I don't really, not super advertising this or anything. This is probably the only time I bring it up, but it's more therapy for me. it helps me organize my thoughts and make me feel better about things, because I realize this. All right, this is fair enough, except for the lag. Oh, dear lord!
Wowie.
Hold tab to see what's going on with it. After you, of course. Stay in the sky because lag. No, it's nothing in particular shitty. Okay, whatever. But yeah, no, I think that that's kind of the big issue with just the way people, if people can't relate, then they don't want to, it's like that same thing of like, I don't understand it, therefore I don't accept it.
Yeah.
It's that same mentality. It's just, I can't, it's just a more personal thing, which is I can't relate to it, which I think is sad, because I mean, it's the same thing about, it's like music, here's a good one, music. So take the rap group NWA. You know, they just had a wonderful biopic, Straight Outta Compton. I've seen it a couple times now, and I cry every time. And it got snubbed for sure.
Oh, it was probably the best movie that came out this year.
Hands down. I would love that movie so fucking much. It was so good. It was so good. But like, I think let's talk about the music of NWA. Like, I think that's like because, let's be honest, white folks can't relate to that kind of music. Therefore, that's why people kept. You almost hit it in your goal.
Oh, that's not my goal.
Oh my God, David, you got it. It's good. You got it. Better that you learned that before you did it.
But, I knew what I was doing.
Okay, I actually thought you for a second, because you were very convincing with what you just said. You're like, oh, that wasn't good. But no, I think that, like, you know, as far as white folks go, we can't relate to that. We don't know what that lifestyle is like. So, like, we can see it on TV. Thank you for nodding along. If you have anything to contribute, please go ahead.
I'm listening.
Okay, great. but no, like, it's one of those things that people just didn't understand it, so they immediately thought it was a song like Fuck the Police is immediately about let's kill every single police officer. It's like, that's not it. Like, you just listen to the actual message. I mean, they do talk about that. Like, it is a thing that is talked about in that song and in various other songs. But, like, it's talked more about, you know, the African-American struggle in South Central. Like, and something that me personally, a boy from suburban Massachusetts, a white boy from suburban Massachusetts, literally could never understand. And, like, I know a lot of people from Massachusetts that have that sort of mentality being like they want to kill all the police. It's just like they don't. They just sometimes don't have a choice but to fight back. Like, because they're not treated with respect and they're not treated like human beings. And like, that's the shitty part. And that's like the whole point of it. It's heartbreaking.
Yeah.
So that kind of goes along with the thing. Like, I relate to John Mayer's music because I can do that. But like, and it, but that's a, although the, lately I've been actually like listening to a shit. Sorry, man. Lately, I've been actually listening to a shitload of NWA and like just a lot of gangster rap. I just like it. I like it from a production standpoint, fantastic. Really. And it's also like really clever. And it also, and if you actually listen to it, I think as a white boy, I'm learning a thing or two about that, where that came from. You know what I mean? Learning about that kind of culture.
By the way, just want to point out how white you are by you keep calling yourself a white boy.
Yeah, because like, I'm a white boy.
It's just such a white boy thing to say.
You're a white boy.
I know. But the way you're saying it is like super white.
Yeah. Because I'm white. Like, I mean, I don't know why you even bothered saying that.
It's just like, I'm astounded by how white you are.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's amazing that I can play the guitar the way I can. To be honest, it's a goddamn miracle. But no, but realistically speaking, that being said, no, I think the reason I emphasize that so much is because I don't want people to think that I'm trying to relate to that. Like, I will never understand. Like, it's just something I can do my best to like support, and I guess I can do what I can to understand it, but I'll never be able to relate. I'll never be able to truly understand on the fundamental level of what that kind of thing is like. I'll be able to see it from an outside perspective. That's all I can ever do, is see it from an outside perspective. Save it, damn it. But, like, that's kind of the thing. I mean, you grew up in L.A., so, like, you were kind of, you, I guess, are more familiar with that kind of thing than I am anyway.
Yeah, but, you know, at the same time, it's still the same. I'll never understand because I don't live that every day. You know, I'm white, I'm Jewish, you know, but... But I, you know, I'm white.
Well, yeah, that. I mean, the Jewish part of you, though. There's some history there.
There's a lot of history there. A lot of history. Yeah. So I understand.
Better than I do.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah. But yeah, no, I, you know, I can only understand what I, it, anybody can only understand what they go through, what they live.
Yeah. Exactly. And the least you can do is just
make an effort to respect, I think. What, like, you know, the...
Well, first of all, we're all humans at the end of the day. Treat people how you want to be treated.
Which is nice. I want to be treated with kindness and respect.
There you go. You put that out, and hopefully you get that back. But
I mean, with the exception of when I'm driving a motor vehicle, I'm a very nice person.
Well, that's just, you know, L.A. will do that to you.
Yeah, L.A. And living in Massachusetts. I mean, we have the nickname Massholes for a reason. Like, that's we're just shitty people.
Well, yeah, that's... You guys are just terrible.
believe it or not, but I will say this about Bostonians. We are the most welcoming people ever. Like, we will welcome you regardless of whatever's going on, but we have no fucking clue what we're talking about. like that's kind of the big thing, is some of the most naive but warm-hearted people that exist in our country are people from New England, specifically Massachusetts. They are completely ignorant idiots, but they are goddamn delightful. They will welcome you into their homes with open arms, and then punch you in the face and get drunk with you. But that's about it. That's about it. So we wanted to end we wanted to end this stream on that note of saying, hey guys, be nice to each other. And that's it. I mean, better than that train wreck on the last stream we had.
That, as you can see, my hair is still short from that haircut.
Yep. I didn't have as many drinks that time, so I only have had one beer, four. Was that the night I broke something? No. That was before you left. For your sister's wedding, right? Or was that after your sister's wedding?
You broke the glass.
That was a couple days ago. That wasn't last. That was a couple days ago.
Couple days ago.
Did we stream that night though? I don't think we streamed that night.
Time is relative.
Time is relative. That's the point of this whole stream, is time is relative.
Yeah.
And what happened a couple days ago? Did I really break the glass, David?
Broken? Well, yeah.
Oh no, you broke it. Broken. I actually, like, I hit my hand against the counter, and then, like, it just went whee, like, flying out of my hand.
And, like, at, like, 1 in the morning, too, and that shit was loud as fuck.
And it was, like, Sunday night, I think.
Oh.
So it was, like, right while people were, you know, getting ready for work in the morning. It was, like, 2, it might have been 2 a.m. And I just, like, sorry. And I was ranting about Game of Thrones, too, and it just totally interrupted it. And I was just like, man, the foreshadowing was incredible and smash. And then I went quiet in shame. I
was like, shame.
Shame. See, it's a spoiler from last season, shame. And it's okay to spoil because it happened a year ago.
But, like, that's out of context. Like, out of context, that...
Cersei Lannister walked naked through King's Landing while somebody walked by her screaming, shame. If you haven't seen it yet, it's your own goddamn fault.
No, it's true. You need to fucking see it.
Hey, you're ending the podcast in the captain's chair for one. Or not podcast. I keep calling it a podcast. You're ending the stream on the captain's chair for one, so that's good. All right, everybody, though, have a good night. Treat each other with respect and love. Peace, love, and time is relative.
Love and mercy.
Another good biopic.
Bye, Opic.